Corros, aquatic faces, mind of its own.
I'm going to show you the middle part, or what would be the bridge section of the title track of the last few Manchu record, which is called Signs of Infinite Power. And the song itself is pretty simple. The basic timing of it is common time 4/4, and the beat is just kind of centered around a 1 and 2. So, to keep it interesting in the middle section, I don't think we consciously decided to do something odd. I think Brad started playing a bass riff, and I was like, oh, that's kind of cool. Maybe we can make something up with it. It ended up being in 6/8, so it's an odd time signature in the middle of a common time signature. So a regular 6/8 beat, as you probably know, the notes are divided into single eighth notes, so you would play instead of 1 and 2 and 3 and 4, and you'd play 6 beats, each worth an eighth of the beat. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So normally you would hear a 6/8 beat like this, with a snare on the 4, kick drum on the 1. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. For all you beginners, if you want to slow that down, just this time signature is a good thing to work on. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So what I decided to do instead is kind of flip that on its head and base it around same time signature, but the beat going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So what I've been doing in the middle of it, when we recorded it, it was really just a lot of flams in the middle section, just going against that time signature, playing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. What it's evolved into over the last 2 years of playing it live is this. So for that section right there, there's a lot of independence going on and some things in weird places, and I'll try and break that down as best I can and show you what it is. Before it comes into the 6 where the roll is. Now, the thing that I did on the end there, which is a... try and put that cowbell in the middle of the fill as if it might be another tom. Since I only have one rack tom, I thought it might kind of sound kind of cool to slip that in there. Sometimes people put cymbals in places where other toms are, and it just kind of makes the fill jump out a little bit more. So at the end of doing that, I'm not quite sure how many times it is. I'll have the recording spliced in here, hopefully, so you can hear it. And the end fill that I do goes... And then that would lead into the regular 6/8 beat. So again, you're coming up with a... So you would want to go kick drum, back, full tom, snare, that's the order. on the top of the one. So if you want to lead with your left hand, I always leave my fills coming off the snare drum with my left hand because it's already easier, it's already in that place, and I'm sort of playing the pattern that way anyway, so it's easier into going. So a lot of people use that as kind of like a, they call a bucket of fish fill. It's really like a single stroke four. To try and make something interesting. And the last part of it is just a follow through 16th where you go, and then that ends up at the end of the fill going into the peak, which again is. With the pattern, I'll play all of it very slow in the beginning. One, two, three. So you have a single stroke four in the middle there, you have 16ths going over the 6-8, a cowbell in the middle of it to make it jump out, and it's actually, that's how it's kind of evolved. It's not exactly how I recorded it, but it's just something that I've stumbled onto, and repetitively, it's actually pretty hard to do every night and do it the same way, but if I can lock into it, then I feel like I've accomplished it, and it's simple enough that it sort of becomes sort of a hypnotic thing, and I don't have to think about it, which is always the funnest stuff to play. So hopefully, I know there's a lot there technically speaking and time wise, but hopefully it gives you a chance at the very least to practice 6-8 and maybe try to come up with something of your own against that time signature in the middle of a 4-4. So the way it sits in the common time signature that we play, the 4-4 going one and two. And hopefully play, because remember, we play, we don't practice. All right, so enjoy, and hopefully we'll have some new stuff coming at you soon. Thanks.